When I go over here and see all this, I don't see the work that was going on before service started. Amen. I don't see that part. See, because I know every pastor got an administration.
Amen.
Amen. And when you get people that's doing four or five different jobs, amen, you can't be effective. Amen. So sometimes we need to look at the fact that what can I do to make it better? Amen. Everybody looking at it, oh mom, what can we do to make it better?
Amen.
Amen. Everybody looking at the community. But what can I do to make my community better?
Yeah.
Amen. It ain't going to get better if I go in and slam the door. God is looking for some vessels that are serious about the condition that we're in.
Amen.
I'm just saying he's looking for a certain kind of vessel. He says to Timothy, stay away from foolish and ignorant disputes because they only generate more strife. Church, we got to learn to stop arguing with people.
Yes.
Amen. The word of God is not to be argued.
Right.
Children, you got to stop learn to stop arguing at school.
Right.
Arguing is only headed to a fight.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
Amazing, even grown folk will argue, amen, with everybody and everything but the devil.
Uh-huh.
Amen. When the devil starts shaking us up, we won't argue with him. We won't put the word of God on him, which is a sure victory for us.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He says to Timothy to stay away from foolish and ignorant disputes. They generate strife. And we know that some people are drama kings and drama queens.
Yeah.
Amen. Give them two words and they'll create a storm.
Yeah.
Amen. That's not a vessel that God wants to use in his ministry.
Yeah.
That's the vessel that Satan uses to all disrupt
right.
the plan
all
of
right.
God.
Right.
Paul says to Timothy that a servant of the Lord should not quarrel, but be gentle with all people
amen.
And be able to teach. In
amen.
Other words, amen, the word of God tells us to, you know, treat evil with kindness.
All right.
Don't let the sun go down on your wrath. You might not wake up in the morning. Always treat evil with kindness.
Amen.
When people come against you, treat them nice.
Amen.
Amen. You don't have anything
Amen.
To lose, but treat
Amen.
Them nice. But you know what? If you don't treat them nice, all you're doing is building heaping coal upon your own head.
Yes.
All you're doing is dampening your own spirit.
All right.
Why are you? Amen.
Amen.
I remember when I was young, I didn't believe in arguing. Amen. See, I love to testify. I didn't believe in arguing. If you come after me with an argument, I promise you I'm going to get the first punch. And I got smart with it, though, Sister Janita. I got smart with it. Don't stop swinging until they grab y'all and break you up. Now you won. Amen. That's the way we need to do the devil. When he comes, get the first punch. And don't stop. Till victory is won.
Right.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
Amen. See, first natural and then spiritual. Amen. So why should I lose energy and get all tired and burn out digging here? Arguing.
Amen.
I don't need that just in case the fight do break out.
Right.
Amen. So you stay calm and cool and be smart. Try to walk away.
Amen.
But if you can't walk away, at least you still got your energy. I used to hear Pastor Hill say people talk about they're going to lay their Holy Ghost down. Mm-hmm. Pastor Hill said, I'm not laying mine down because I want all the Holy Ghost I can get behind my front.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
God is looking for some people that's bold enough to stand up against the devil and help build his church back to where he once had.
Yes.
A church with power.
Amen.
Amen. A church with healing power. A church with deliverance power. I didn't come to tell y'all the story today, but I am getting ready to go to my seat. Amen. Paul says that the servant of the Lord should not quarrel, but be gentle to all people. He didn't say some people. You know, even those who treat you bad. What does the scripture say? Pray for those who despitefully misuse you. Y'all use the word those who are in opposition, amen, praying that God will grant them repentance, that they may know the truth. That's what Paul said to Timothy. I want you to teach this just like this. That's what Paul said to Timothy. You know, so those who come against you, amen, you praying for them that God will grant them a repentance. And when God grants somebody repentance, that means that you got some more help. Amen. You got some more help. All I'm saying is, when you do it like that, Paul said, if God grants them repentance, then maybe they'll come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil. I'm just saying that God is looking for some messages that have been tried and defied and have come through as Spirit God. Are you that kind of vessel that God can use? Have you been tried and defined? Have you come through as Spirit God? Don't fool me. Amen. Have you really been tried in the fire? Amen. You see, even the loss of a loved one, that's not really being tried in the fire. Lost your job, that's a pretty heavy test. But it takes more than that to be tried and come through this door.